silence. That's something rare in urban life. Where do you find silence? And does it just exist, or is it something you have to consciously design to make a place for silence in our busy cities where over half of the world's populations live? The artist and architect Sarah van Sonsbeek is artist in residence at the Amsterdam Academy of Architecture this semester, and her winter studio is about silence.
Why silence?
Well, I'm an artist now, but I became an artist because of my horrible neighbors, and they interested me actually in, well, the opposite of what they were doing. Their noise is silence.
Can you explain?
Well, I was graduating at the Rietveld Academy, and then I had these horrible noisy neighbors, and in a fit of desperation, I wrote them a letter asking them to pay that amount of my rent they were taking up with their noise. I never got an answer, but it made me aware of how, let's say, mental architecture is really determining our space. And it's a thing I never learned in architecture school in Delft in my time. But things like silence, sound, ownership, maybe the view from your window are just as important as the physical things.
And the students here, about 180 students, are working on thinking about silence, what it is it an absence, is it a presence? And how to use silence or create silence in their designs, in their future practice, when they go into the professional world.
Silence is mostly in your head, I think. You know that you're alone in a forest. And that idea gives you mental silence. I think mental silence is dominant above the noise of things.
I'm asking the students to design a silence for the Kop of Java Eiland in the Ei River right behind Central Station. And it's perhaps one of the few really empty and silent spots now still existing in Amsterdam. But I believe you need to design silence because it doesn't come of its own accord, and if you don't design it, perhaps you may lose it.
The Window Show. That's the wonderful name that the Amsterdam illustrators Aniek Bartels and Joelle Weekamp thought up for this project of theirs in the Haarlemmerstraat in Amsterdam. They thought, you know, it's really hard for artists to find a place to exhibit their work. Why don't we go to shows, to shops, which have automatically places to exhibit things, namely the shop window. The one behind me, Concrete Matters, is by an illustrator named Guy Verbeek, and there are wonderful discoveries to be made all through the Haarlemmerstraat by Amsterdam illustrators for the Window Show. Land and water, dunes and dikes, sand and flood, tides, the movements of nature, the movements of wind and the earth. Those are the ingredients of the work of landscape architect and artist Bruno Dudens. He's made some wonderful, impressive works, often huge works, with huge machines moving around tremendous amounts of sand to make us feel and understand how those natural processes impact our landscape. And of course, living in the Netherlands, where the country has to be defended from the sea because otherwise the country would disappear, the relationship between land and water and tides and flooding is essential to understanding what it means to live in the Netherlands. Every year, Bruno organizes a gathering to tell us about his projects of the last year. And I'm going to go inside here in the Ketelhuis, the movie theater at the Westergas Works, and hear about what he's up to.
De open structuurkwelder, geïnspireerd op het schilderij Pier en Oceaan van Mondriaan, brengt techniek, verbeelding en natuur samen.
what I notice in the beautiful films that you and Andras Hammelberg make about dynamic coastal management is how much heavy machinery is involved in Dutch nature.
Yeah. Yeah, actually we have to do it with machines, because the bigger part of making dikes, making dunes, that's all by big machines. In the old days they did it by hand. I mean, the afsluitdijk is made by a lot of effort, just by manpower. And it's amazing to see. I mean, in the 1200, all these dikes are just man-made.
There's a new project coming up in the Netherlands. The afsluitdijk, the enclosure dike, is being renewed, and they're building an experience center. You'll have a project at the experience center. What can we experience at the enclosure dike?
Yeah, actually it's nice. There's a fish migration river coming there in the next years, and part of that...
Fish migration? Where are they migrating to and from?
From the Waddenzee to the rivers. They asked me if I could make it visible to the audience, because fishes are under the water and the bigger ecosystem is so big you can't see. So you need other ways of explaining this. And so I made tijdkijkers in Dutch, and they express the essence of the landscape in 1 minute. So you look to the east, and then you see the whole development of Friesland in 1 minute from 1,000 years. The same to the south, when there was still no afsluitdijk in the beginning. And also the Waddenzee, the north, about the dynamics and the extreme quality of these dynamics for the whole Waddenzee.